name of our entrance antiphon. These are the holy men whom the Lord chose in his own perfect love. To them he gave eternal glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The apostles were the friends and followers of the Lord and gave their lives for him, shedding
he spent the night in prayer to God. When day came, he called his disciples to himself, and from them he chose 12, whom he also named apostles: Simon, whom he named Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, Simon, who was called a Zealot, and Judas, the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. My sisters and brothers, this is the good news, the gospel of the Lord. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations. Those are the words that God spoke to Jeremiah, the prophet, hundreds of years before the birth of Jesus. They may very well have been spoken, we're not told this, this is my surmising, they may very well have been spoken by God to the humanity of Jesus. Remember, he is human and he is also divine. And those same words, I believe, have been spoken to you and to me, and our baptism is a sign of that. And if you go back and look these up in the first chapter of Jeremiah, Jeremiah's response is very much like the response many of us give to God. I can't do that. I'm too young. I don't know how to speak. And God says something very important to him. Don't say you're too young. He may say to us, don't say I'm not a priest, I'm not a deacon, I'm not a nun, I can't do this. Say not you're too young, he says to Jeremiah. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you to speak, you shall speak to them. And do not be afraid, because I am with you. Then he reached out, says Jeremiah, and he touched his mouth. See, your sin is removed. I'm putting my word in your mouth. Our faith tells us, every one of us has heard that one way or another, whether we accepted it or not, or believed it or not, from the moment of our baptism. I think of that when I look at this very short gospel passage today. You've heard me say many times, I say it because I believe it to be true. Words are important. But very often, we let holy words roll off our tongues and we never stop to think about what it is we're saying. Jesus has gathered around himself a larger group of followers. He's called them his disciples. But out of that larger group, he chose 12. That's the key word. He chose 12. And as I was looking at this, I found myself thinking, why did he choose those 12? They are average, ordinary people, just like you, just like me. They're not great giants. They don't have an ancient world equivalent to a PhD in Jewish theology or the Jewish law. They're not teachers. They're not rabbis. In that culture, at that time, the lowest group of people in the society, they don't use words like class like we use today, but the lowest group of people are the slaves. And a cut above them are the average ordinary folks, just like you, just like me. And if we were to put our terminology today into the words of the Pharisees in the time So say not, I'm not a priest, I'm not a deacon, I'm not a nun. But let those words God spoke to Jeremiah resonate in your heart. Think about them. I always like to encourage people, I don't know if you've ever done this, I've said this before, it might be fun to sit down and draw a timeline of your life. And then see if you can identify moments in that timeline when you would say,
unless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church, be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all of your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and proclaim
remember, O Lord, your servants Francis and Pope. But remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the signs of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Give them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who do sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously share in fellowship with your holy apostles and monks, with John the Baptist and Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints, St. Simon and Jude. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with light, bless them, and bestow them upon us.